Good afternoon.
Hello everyone. I'm Dr. Sonia. I'm an ophthalmologist practicing in Bangalore, Karthik Netralaya Eye Hospital. So as we all know, cataract is a very common eye problem, and cataract surgery is one of the most commonly done surgery on human body. Now, I'm sure most of you must have somebody in the family or friends who has undergone cataract surgery or who has been advised cataract surgery. And whenever we hear about cataract surgery, the next question which comes to our mind is about the intraocular lens, or IOL, which your doctor must have told that you have to put after the cataract surgery. So you will have a lot of questions about the lens, about the cataract. So to answer all those questions, today we have Dr. M.S. Ravindra with us, who is a world-renowned cataract and refractive surgeon. He is also the founder and medical director of Karthik Netralaya Eye Hospital, Bangalore. Welcome, sir. So today we want to know all about cataract and intraocular lenses. So first of all, the most commonly asked question is, what is a cataract?
Okay. Have a nice day, Dr. Sonia. I'll use a model to explain what a cataract is. That's the eye, as you see from front, cornea. If I open the eye, behind the cornea there is a pupil. You can see my finger through that. And behind that is a lens. You can see from a side. That's a cornea, that's the iris, that's the lens. So the two lenses, the cornea is a powerful lens, that's accommodating lens. These two will focus the light onto the macula. The information from the macula goes to the brain through the optic nerve here, goes to the brain, and the brain sees the objects that we see all around us. So with age, just like so many things happen in our body, the lens also becomes opaque. Instead of it being transparent, now it becomes an opaque like that. So an opaque lens is called a cataract. Many people think cataract means there's a layer which goes on the eye. It's certainly not. It's a lens of the eye which becomes opaque. Then initially it scatters the light. Not that suddenly the vision goes away. The vision gradually blurs over a period of time. Any glass that you change will not remain so, and the vision continues to drop. You will have difficulties in driving, you have difficulties in writing, reading, or you may have difficulties in seeing in little dim light. There's so many ways of cataract and so many ways of the presentation. But whatever it is, when the cataract is presented, you should ask the doctor, is it the time to get operated? So many times doctor will say yes, or it depends upon your work profile. Imagine you do a very fine job, your visual needs are very high, you work on system for real long hours, you are a you have to see the world clearly, then cataract can be operated in early stages. It doesn't have to be mature. But if you're a person who would like to wait for, you know, your visual needs are not much, then you can wait till certain stage, then it becomes essential to do cataract surgery. But cataract certainly should not mature. Maturity is a bad stage in cataract. Your vision is grossly reduced. You will have difficulty in walking around. You will have difficulty. You may fall, in dim light. You may have, one of the biggest thing is driving becomes more difficult, increasingly more and more difficult, especially with the oncoming lights. It's a risk actually. Little water on the floor, you may not be able to see, you may skid and fall. So these are the accidents which does occur because in old age, vision becomes very, very essential. The cataract procedure, basically, what does it mean? We'll remove the opaque lens and we'll replace with a transparent lens. The new lens is called intraocular lens. Intra means inside, ocular means eye, lens means it's inside the eye. So this will replace the original lens and you'll start having the good vision.
So whenever we say you have to do cataract surgery, hearing of surgery, you get scared. So let's see whether it's really scary and what are the different types of surgeries which are done for cataract.
Yeah, that's a good question, Dr. Sonia. Cataract surgery has been one of the most advanced technological wonder among all the surgeries done on the human being. It's a very delicate surgery. Probably I would call it as the finest surgery that can be ever be done on the human body. And it's become very safe because it's done so frequently and repetitively all over the world. The equipment are available now. Safety factor is never heard of. So much of safety is there in the cataract. And almost every patient will have reasonably good vision after the surgery, whatever we target. There are emergencies, there are bad things that can happen. Just like when you start driving a car, it doesn't mean that all the time you reach safely. It may be your fault, it may be somebody else's fault, things can go wrong, but by and large, it's an extremely safe procedure.
So are there different techniques of cataract surgery?
There are many, many techniques. You ask the doctor what technique suits your eye best. And I've heard about, I've seen a video of some fantastic surgery. And you don't go and ask the doctor to do that particular surgery because every eye is different. Every eye has got different structure, different function. Your visual needs are different. And the technique of cataract, it is called phacoemulsification. Oh. It's called MICS, microincision cataract surgery. In both of them, we make three openings. We make one opening, two opening, three openings, tiny openings, and we go inside the eye and remove it. There are techniques called MSICS, where there is a single opening, and there are techniques called phacosuction. There are many different techniques, and depending upon the cataract that you have, the surgeon decides which technique is best for your eye and least damaging to the delicate structures of your eye.
Okay, let's now come to the intraocular lens,
okay,
which is the most commonly asked question by patients, because sometimes patients are told that this lens is better for you. Sometimes they are told you can choose whatever lens you want to choose. Mm. So how do you decide which lens you have to choose? And first of all, you tell what is an intraocular lens?
I'll just show you one lens. This is one of the modern lenses that's implanted in the eye. If this can be zoomed and you can actually see the lens. That's one of the lenses, as you can see. The lens diameter is about 6 millimeters. You can see the diameter is, it has got two haptics, these are the ones which hold, and the entire lens can be flexed. I can bend it here. See, I'm folding it now, and we can fold the lens. It's never touched with the hand. This is a waist lens. It's always handled with the instruments. And now I have folded the lens. So these are called foldable lenses which go inside the eye through a tiny incision. Is that all right? You can see this?
Yeah.
Okay. I can put a background on my hand there. So that's an actual lens that's implanted in the eye. So when we look at a magnified version of it, that's one of the this big one.
Yeah.
Okay, the same thing is big one. Mm-hmm. And this can be folded and we can put inside through a small, and that's a lens. Material wise, there are different kinds of lenses. One is the time when Harold Ridley discovered this way back 40 or 50 years ago. It used to be made of perspex or polymethyl methacrylate. Then came the silicon lenses, which are foldable. Then came the hydroxy, which are acrylic made lenses, which are hydrophobic lenses. Then came the latest lenses, which are hydrophobic. That means the whole lens this is a hydrophobic lens. There's no water in it. So it's full dry status. It's lathed in a dry status. So these are the best lenses, material wise. Then if you go into the, there's nothing called good lens or bad lens. All lenses will work. Whatever lens doctor has chosen to implant, whether it is low cost budget or high cost budget or a very premium lenses, they're all serve very good. There is nothing like a bad lens. All are good lens. You choose any lens in the package, it's a good lens and you'll have wonderful vision. That is the baseline on which we want to work. And then why should some lenses cost more, some lenses cost less? Why should, there are so many grades of lenses. Yes. It's basically, to take an example, if you take a car, for example, all cars are good today on the road. All of them drive you wherever you want to go. They're comfortable. There's air conditioning. Mm. So they protect you. So all are there, but why some cars are more expensive? It depends upon the brand of company which has made it. They put in a lot of efforts. Some of the technological advances are patented. They are there in some of them. Some designs can be made by only one company. They have the technology, they have the appropriate lathes to do it. So they obviously they charge more for their lenses. So what is the advantage to the patient? As I said, the baseline is all lenses give excellent vision. There's nothing like you put a bad lens and the eye becomes rotten, nothing. Second point is all lenses will last lifelong. There's no way you can, after 5 years you change it and put another lens. After 20 years you change. We put for children and they last for 100 years. Yeah. So the lifetime is all the time. There's no need to remove a lens for any good reason in present day technology. The third thing is, you can remove the power that you have. Imagine there's a person who is wearing -8 glasses, +10 glasses, +20 glasses. All along the life he has tried to struggle. This is one good opportunity in lifetime. It comes only once. After 10 years, you cannot come back to repair it, sir. There's no question of repairing, taking out the lens and putting a new one. So you choose what you want right now and don't leave it to your thought processes where you would like to think in a different way. Put all your efforts to learn about what is that you want after the surgery. So, whatever power you have in the past, imagine some people have cylindrical powers. Cylindrical power is the power here is different, power here is different. So, that can be corrected by putting a lens, like a toric lens. So you see these little dots there. So, power here and power here are different. So, we align it to suit your the error inside the eye, and that corrects your cylindrical power. So, imagine somebody has got minus 1.5 cylinders at 180 degrees. That can be corrected with either this, or we have another special technique called limbal relaxing incisions, or LRI. You can use that and correct the cylindrical power. That's one of the beautiful, most elegant way of correcting your power. And in case, you know, after 40 years, everybody will have a reading power. You see distance, then for reading, you'll have to wear glasses. So, can I avoid that is one of the questions very commonly asked. Yes, there is a very elegant way. These are called multifocal lenses. You can see the rings there, but they are very fine rings of few, less than 1 micron in height. So, these rings will see that some parts of the lens are focused at this distance, some parts of the lens focus near. So, without wearing glasses, you will be able to see reasonably well for distance and reasonably well for near. Now, these are bifocal lenses. Now, currently, there are something called trifocal lenses that are available, or extended depth of field, EDF lenses are available. These two are different categories. EDF will increase the range of your vision, while trifocals will focus at that distance, will focus at this distance and focus near. There are three levels of focus. So, these are ultimate lenses. These are designed especially considering the today's needs that people work on laptops, people work on desktops, people use mobiles, and people drive around, walk around. So, considering all the three levels, the trifocals and EDFs are designed.
So, are all the people, like they can get a multifocal lens done, or there are
No. Everybody will not be suitable to have, everybody is suitable to have, whether you have myopia, whether you have some disease, diabetic retinopathy, optic nerve neuritis, any disease in the eye, they are suitable to undergo a cataract surgery. Whether they get complete vision or they get partial vision, whether they get half vision depends upon the health of the retina and the nerve. For example, in a glaucoma patient where the nerve is damaged, in a diabetic retinopathy, the macula is damaged, you may not expect to see full vision. These are perfect, but light comes and falls on this, and the retina doesn't work fully, so you'll not see fully. So, there are limiting factors based upon the health of the eye. All that has to be checked. There's another rare condition called, I won't say rare, but it's often seen in that age group, it's called macular degeneration. The macula gets spoiled in old age, just like Alzheimer's disease damages the brain. The macula also is an age-related disease which damages the macula. So, if the macula is healthy, then you'll have very good vision. So, macular health has to be assessed by a test called the OCT. So, we do an OCT to ensure that the macula is very healthy, because somebody who is going to spend a lot of money on an EDF lens or a trifocal or a multifocal lens, they would like to be assured that they'll get good vision. Okay. So, that assurance only comes when you do a couple of tests. Okay.
So, multifocal lenses are considered to be little more expensive than a monofocal.
They are expensive.
So, if there is a person who cannot afford that much, but he still wants to have a good distance and near vision, then is there any option for them?
Yeah, he certainly has an option. With the existing monofocal lenses like this, which are low-cost lenses, what we do is we have two eyes. Okay, both eyes work synchronizingly, and the vision of right eye, the vision of left eye, they superimpose. And then it goes to the brain and you see one object. The right eye is seeing differently, left eye is seeing differently, you see one object. That's a 3D object. With each eye, you see only 2D. With two eyes, it becomes a three-dimensional object. So, what we do at this stage, there is a level at which the brain can accommodate focality of the right eye, focality of the left eye. So, it's up to 5, minus 5 diopters. But if you are within, say, 1.5 diopters, your depth of field is not disturbed. So, we'll take that as an advantage. What we'll do is there is a dominant eye. So, in case you are shooting or something, you always close one eye and see with one eye. So, that's your dominant eye. Maybe it's right eye, maybe it's left eye. So, dominant eye will focus for distance, and the non-dominant eye will focus for near. And the difference in the power is around 1 to 1.5. If we keep that, they'll have wonderful vision. They'll be able to see with both eyes. They'll be able to see with both the eyes for distance. Between the two eyes, One eye will work more for distance, other eye will work. This is called monovision. That's an excellent option if you would like to save money and get the beautiful lenses. Also, you can combine different kinds of lenses. So there is a lens called negative asphericity lenses, which kind of correct, which do excellent contrast. Negative aspherical lenses are the range of lenses which are available easily, not very expensive. They correct very good contrast, that you put it in the dominant eye. Then another lens called positive aspherical lenses. The doctor will choose whether you are fit for it, and that will give extended depth of field, and that's for the non-dominant eye. There's various ways, and you have to sit with the doctor and tell your needs. What are the things? Doctor will ask you, what are the things you do from morning till night? What are the things you do in that range? What are the things you do in that range? There is a, that data is generated by the doctor, and he will probably guide you what's best for you.
So today, nowadays, sorry. Nowadays, cataract surgery has become more of a refractive surgery.
Exactly.
So it's not only about getting rid of your cataract, but also to provide you good vision after the surgery according to your needs. So anything else in you would like to say to our patients who are about to get cataract surgery, what they should ask their doctor about the lenses?
The first question they ask is, how much is going to cost? Mm. The second question they ask generally is, I've got an insurance company, they give some money, and can you do a surgery within that? I think both are questions which a doctor cannot answer. Yeah. It is like going to a shop and asking, how much does a car cost? So you'll have to identify the car first, yeah, whether you would like to have a Maruti car or, some other car. Identify what you want, then the doctor will tell you. You go to your hotel, you say, how much does it breakfast cost? So you to tell him how, what you want to eat, dosa, idli or whatever it is. Mm. So based upon that, we will see. So ideally, I think you should not worry about it. Budget comes later. So we would like to work with the intention. Today it's possibility. Mm. 20 years ago, it was not possible. 5 years ago, it was not possible. Today it's a possibility to get back the best thing as far as vision is concerned, the best. You can really enjoy. That's one opportunity for you to get rid of your power, get rid of your spectacles completely. We can collect your cylindrical power, we can collect your spherical power, you'll be able to see distance, near, intermediate, all of them. It's a possibility. And the only thing is, they become little premier, little become expensive. So you decide upon, you get the, go through the test. We'll do an extensive test. One of the tests is called cataract workstation. So that's the cataract workstation report. It gives complete data of how the endothelial cells are there. If endothelial cells are not up to the mark, I mean, you will potentially, there is an opportunity for you to lose vision over a period of time. So we need to protect every endothelial cells by additional mechanisms like viscoelastics. Surgical techniques will be different to protect them. So this is called specular microscopy, which is very important. It gives steep axis and flat axis. It gives the size of the pupil in bright light, the size of the pupil in dim light. You can see the two different sizes. So we know exactly what are the difficulties you have while driving, what are the difficulties you're going to have while walking in dim light, what are the difficulties you have, whether you would like to have a lens which is a very premium lens and corrects your gives the best contrast vision at dim light. What is contrast vision when you go to a theater? Movie has already started, lights are little dim, you struggle to walk in and reach your seat. But next person walks, runs and sits there. The difference is dim light contrast. So that can be improved to certain extent. It again, it's a function of both the focusing of the light as well as the nerve strength. And that is the curvature of the cornea. If there is huge difference in the colors, you will not be eligible for the specialty premier lenses. These are all the data. With ultrasound, we take all the measurements. Corneal curvature is taken with keratometry. Ultrasound takes the different measurements, anterochamber depth, lens thickness, axial length, all are measured. And based upon this data, we will tell you what's the best lens that's good for you, next best lens that's good for you, third lens best. And then the price comes in. You tell, my affordability is only this much, sir, what will you offer? So we will work out the best that suits both your budget as well as the visual needs of the patient.
So communication with your doctor is also very important. You should tell your needs, what are your visual needs, what do you do in your day-to-day life. Talk to your doctor about the health of your eye, whether you are suitable for all kind of lenses or not. Then you make an informed decision. So I think we have got most of our questions answered. So we would like to thank Dr. Ravindra for his time. And if you have any other queries, please leave them in the comment section, or you can also contact us or on our phone or email, and we will surely get back to you. Thank you for watching.